Greetings, Father D. Dear students. In the chain of my lectures on alkaloids, this is my fourth lecture, and today I will discuss the structure or the constitution of quinine. So, we'll discuss some physical as well as some properties of quinine. Quinine is a well-known bitter antimalarial drug occurring among the alkaloids of cinchona bark and remiza. Cinchona bark contains about 30 alkaloids, but its antimalarial activity is mainly due to quinine, quinidine, cinchonine and cinchonidine. Pure quinine and cinchonine were the first isolated in 1820 by Pelletier and Caventou. We'll discuss some properties of quinine. Quinine is a white crystalline, antipyretic, analgesic, anti-inflammatory and anti-malarial compound. Quinine is insoluble in water. It melts at 177 degrees centigrade in anhydrous condition. It is laboratory and has a bitter taste. Now we'll discuss its constitution or the structure. First we'll take its molecular formula. From the elemental analysis and molecular weight determination, it follows that the molecular formula of quinine is C20H24N2O2. Now it contains two nitrogen atoms. We have to ascertain the nature of the two nitrogen atoms. It has been found that the two nitrogen atoms are tertiary in nature, as quinine adds to 2 moles of methyl iodide to form diquaternary salt. It is a ditertiary base as indicated, as represented in this reaction. Now we have to ascertain the functional nature of oxygen. It has been found that quinine contains a secondary alcoholic group, as quinine forms a monoacetate and a monobenzoate. It means that quinine must contain one OH group. However, this is a secondary alcoholic group, which is shown by the fact that quinine on oxidation gives a ketone, quininone. So we can say that there is a secondary alcoholic group in the molecule of quinine. Now next we will ascertain the presence of a methoxyl group. When quinine is heated with hydrochloric acid, it eliminates 1 mole of methyl chloride, indicating that a methoxyl group is present in quinine. It means that the second oxygen atom in the molecule of quinine is found to be present as a methoxyl group. Presence of an olefinic linkage. As quinine adds on one molecule of bromine, it indicates that quinine must contain one ethylenic double bond. The same is also proved by the fact that quinine absorbs a molecule of hydrogen in the presence of catalyst. The presence of an olefinic linkage is further proved by its formation of hydrogen substituted compounds with halogen acids, as it is indicated in this reaction that it adds 1 mole of hydrogen and 1 mole of bromine. Presence of a vinyl group. When controlled oxidation of quinine is done with KMnO4, it yields a monocarboxylic acid along with formic acid. This reaction reveals that the vinyl group is present in quinine. Presence of a quinoline nucleus. When quinine is fused with concentrated potassium hydroxide, it yields a mixture of 6-methoxyquinoline and lapidine. Lapidine is 4-methoxyquinoline along with other products. These products prove that quinoline nucleus is present in quinine. Cinchonine, when fused with potassium hydroxide under the same conditions, yields quinoline and lapidine, indicating that quinine is methoxycinchonine. Presence of miroquinine. When oxidation of quinine is done with chromic acid, it produces, among other products, quininic acid, as we can see in this reaction. On the other hand, controlled oxidation of quinine with chromic acid yields quininic acid and other component known as second half, commonly known as miroquinine, as I have shown in this reaction. In order to establish the structure of quinine, the structure of these oxidation products, that is quininic acid and miroquinine, should be established. First, we'll establish the structure of quininic acid. When quininic acid is heated with soda lime, it undergoes decarboxylation, yielding 6-methoxyquinoline. The position 6 of methoxyl group has been confirmed by the conversion of quininic acid to 6-hydroxyquinoline by heating with hydrochloric acid. These points are indicated in the following series of reaction. When quininic acid is oxidized with chromic acid, it yields pyridine 2,3,4 tricarboxylic acid. It is evident that benzene ring of the letter, that is quininic acid, having the methoxy group is oxidized. The carboxylic group at C4 reveals that in quininic acid also, the carboxylic group is present at position 4. This is indicated in the reaction. When quininic acid is heated with hydrochloric acid to yield demethylated product, which on decarboxylation yields 6-hydroxyquinoline. This reaction shows that the methoxy group in quininic acid is present in 6th position. All these facts support the structure 1 for quininic acid, which is shown in this equation. Now we will take the structure of miroquinine. Its molecular formula has been found to be C9H15NO2. As it forms monosodium salt as well as an ester, it reveals the presence of carboxylic group. When miroquinine is reduced with hydrogen, it takes up one molecule of hydrogen, suggesting that ethylenic double bond is present in it. The presence of ethylenic double bond indicates that CH double bond CH2, that is side chain, is still present in miroquinine, as we can see in this equation. When miroquinine is oxidized with cold acidified KM4, it yields syncolopinic acid, which is a dicarboxylic acid, and formic acid. The formation of formic acid reveals the presence of CH double bond CH2, that is vinyl group side chain in miroquinine, as we can see in this equation. As miroquinine can be benzoylated, acetylated and nitrosated, forms nitroso derivative with HNO2, it means that secondary amino group is present in miroquinine. When syncolopinic acid is oxidized with acid permanganate, it yields loiponic acid, that is C7H11NO4. As loiponic acid is a dicarboxylic acid and contains one methylene group less than its precursor, syncolopinic acid, it means that the latter contains at least a side chain, that is CH2COOH. Loiponic acid has been somewhat less stable and it isomerizes to more stable hexahydrosyncomeranoic acid, that is C7H11NO4, that is piperidine 3,4 dicarboxylic acid, on treatment with KOH at about 200 degree centigrade. Hence, loiponic acid should also be piperidine 3,4 dicarboxylic acid. As we can see, in presence of KOH, it isomerizes into a more stable form. Loiponic acid contains one CH2 less than the syncolipoic acid. So syncolipoic acid should be either structure 1 or structure 2. On heating with HCl, it produces 2,4-dimethylpyridine, and on heating with concentrated sulfuric acid, it gives gamma picolin. This is shown in this reaction. So miroquinine gives syncolipoic acid along with formic acid on oxidation, so it should be either structure A or structure B, as I have shown these two structures in the following diagram. Structure A is found to be correct since miroquinine forms 3-ethyl-4-methylpyridine. For the formation of this product is only possible with the when we assume structure A for miroquinine. Miroquinine on reduction with zinc and hydrogen iodide gives syncolipoic, which has carboxylic group and ethyl group. Structure B cannot account for the formation of syncolipoic, so the structure of miroquinine is undoubtedly A. We know that quinine forms quininic acid, which contains quinoline nucleus and miroquinine on oxidation, as we have studied previously. So quinine does not contain carboxylic group, showing that the two moieties are linked through those carbon atoms. Quinine is a di-tertiary base, but miroquinine contains a secondary nitrogen atom and a carboxylic group, showing that during oxidation, tertiary nitrogen atom changes to secondary and a carboxylic group is formed. This is possible only when nitrogen atom is a part of condensed ring system like shown in this diagram. Here this is 3-vinylquinolidine, and upon oxidation with chromic acid it gives miroquinine. From the above facts, we can conclude that quinine is the quinoline nucleus, that in quinine the quinoline nucleus is joined at position 4 and the quinosylidine at position 8. The last thing is to be fixed is the location of the secondary alcoholic group. On oxidation, quinine to quinone by using CrO3, quinone on treatment with amyl nitrite and HCl gave quininic acid and an oxime. This shows that the methylene group is present adjacent to a carbonyl group, which is formed from a CHOH group linking the two molecules. Thus we can say with the help of foregoing reactions that the structure of quinine is as represented in this diagram, and this structure of quinine is further confirmed by its synthesis. Here we have taken the synthesis of quinine given by Woodward and Doering, who prepared quinoxine, which has previously converted to quinine. The local synthesis starts from M-methyl benzaldehyde, obtained from benzaldehyde by nitration, reduction of nitro group with stannous chloride, diazotization and treatment with boiling water, as we can see in this series of reaction, and finally we get quinine. So this was all about the constitution or the structure of quinine. Thank you. Have a nice day.